started this idea way back in 2016 when I was still Miss Tourism. When we're looking at this, we are looking at different global destinations that are known for their foods. For example, Italy for pizza, Chinese noodles, we have the Japanese sushi, and now the Uganda roll.
Rolexes,
when there are many, or there are still Rolex.
Rolexes, and the Rolex.
Tell your neighbor, Kabako is in town.
As you can see, it was incredibly successful at the last edition of the Rolex Festival. It was actually the third one. We continue with our review right here on Backstage Pass. On Urban, we are joined by John Paul, yes, and we continue our conversation. This time onto the Rolex Festival. I remember going there for one of the first ones. It must have been the second one, actually. And it showed a lot of promise. I love the fact that they had so many creative Rolexes from different parts of Uganda, but you know, incorporating different parts of Uganda. They also had Rolex incorporating different parts of the world, as a matter of fact. I remember there's some Mexican guys who tried to add a little nice different touch to the Rolex. It was a very amazing affair, great day for the family as well. And the last one, unfortunately, I couldn't go for because it was literally jam-packed. What happened? What took the Rolex Festival into the sky? How did it become literally the most attended event of the year?
You see, the Rolex Festival, when it came up, was in 2016, people thought it was just a usual event.
Yeah.
Like the name Rolex, like what is going to happen there? But there is, every single time when you come up with an idea, you're able to know what more to add up. So on the first event, it was slightly just trying to pick up. And then after that, there was some negative attitude towards the Rolex Festival. And that was a blessing, these guys, because it was the talk of, it was an event which was talked about globally.
Yes.
And it trended everywhere. So I think that gave it another peak in terms of the numbers, in terms of those that didn't show up to come and experience what happens there. But most important, for the last year's event, it was well advertised.
Yeah.
And it had actually now cut across the global scene.
Yes.
And that's why it attracted a number of sponsors, a number of revealers, and by the time people came through, they had to come through and surely get to see what really happens. Because in the first event, that was 2016, we had different types of Rolexes.
Yes.
And for us, we knew about one type of Rolex.
That's true.
So when people saw the pictures, they're like, oh, there is a Malewa chicken Rolex, there is a chicken Rolex, there is so quite a variety. So this time around, people came to see the experience, to see exactly how these things are made. And the setup plan also probably attracted the families. Like we've seen in the visuals, kids were catered for. They have their section with bouncing castles. So it was an event that not only attracted people to come and see the Rolexes, but still the experience. What am I going to have in terms of fun, in terms of engagement? So I believe it's something that really gave the revealers to come and be a part of it.
That was the third edition, and now it's back for the fourth edition. And yeah. We got to have an experience, or rather, an insight on what to experience with the fourth edition that is coming up. Are there a couple of things you'd like to see happen, apart from the obvious one, which is the venue change this time around?
Yes. Still, I cannot fail to talk about the venue. Like you said, you even came and you were unable to get in because it was about four and they had to stop the numbers.
Yes.
The person who is there to make money believes it's something that needs to be done. You may even feel like they should actually just extend all the buildings around. But one thing that I believe it's going to be bigger and better, it's the venue. Mm-hmm. That's Cricket Oval. We cannot roll it out. That it gives you ample space in terms of park, in terms of engaging. So that's one thing. Two, this time around, we intend to have quite a number of activities going to happen. Not just a Rolex bit of it, but like you mentioned, that last year we had different Rolexes from different world.
Yeah.
Not only just from different parts of Uganda. So we're trying to reach out so many people from different countries because we believe they have also mastered on how to do their own Rolexes culture. That's Yitare, German. So it's also going to be another experience to see different crowds coming in from different countries to come and be a part of this.
Yeah.
And then, of course, we can't rule out the section of the kids. It's a family affair.
Uh-huh.
It's a Sunday. And like you said, Sundays are now taking over. So we'll have our families catered for kids, play areas, board games for their friends, great music, because now things are now bigger and better.
Yeah.
Yes.
Thank you very much for that. Another thing that is going to be happening pretty soon as we look forward to the weekend is My Culture, My Identity. One particular event that's all about embracing our culture and our identity. This will be coming up also this weekend. Are you looking forward to that one and why?
Yes, true. I'll definitely be there.
Yeah?
Yes, I'll be there because anything that is about culture, definitely it is part of us. It has a responsibility, we as Ugandans, to go and embrace our culture, norms, our dressings, our food. It is it is our event. So definitely, I cannot miss out on this one.
Fine. Let's check out what happened at the press launch and we'll find out what exactly we can expect from this event coming up right now.
Grandmothers used to go move from there to from everywhere they were working from, and they come putting on a gomesi and they feel comfortable. Our fashion show will be produced by the one and only Joram Job Mzira Job.
So what we will be bringing is we're going to have a merge of Uganda, Kenya, Tanzania, literally all the African countries, merge them together and just give you the best show ever.
My name is Ofkatolam George. I'm from Tik Tech. So we've made partnership with Culture World to sell tickets officially.
I'm pleased to be teaming up with Culture World for the My Identity Festival on the at Uganda Museum. And this is going to be the most fun and exciting day for us in Uganda, because we have so many tribes in Uganda. We speak more than 200 languages in Uganda. So imagine all these tribes in Uganda being in one place. The food, the dance, the music, the games. We all have different cultures. We all come from different parts. We all have different tribes. So imagine just everybody being in one place, so happy, eating, dancing, playing all these games. Hi, guys.
Well, as we look forward to My Culture, My Identity, you know, we've got quite a number of cultures that identify us as Ugandan.
Yeah.
And these are supposedly going to be showcased at this particular event.
Yeah, sure.
Maybe we have too many cultures for one particular show. Won't we need a whole week of activities?
It is something that I've also thought about.
Yeah.
Because we have about over 200 cultures.
Yeah.
Over 200. And we look at the venue, Uganda Museum, I feel it's a bit small. Mm-hmm. If at all everyone says, let's go and embrace our culture.
Yeah.
If the Waganda say, let's get that. If the Banyankore, if anyone from different cultures say, let's go, I believe we're going to have what we experienced last year in the Rhodes Festival.
Yeah.
Yes, so it is a good event, I should say, because it is our event. It is embracing us. It is taking us back to our roots.
Yes.
Letting us know what we are supposed to put on, because it's cutting across different things.
Mm-hmm.
In clothes, in terms of food, in terms of drink, so many things that really identify us.
Yeah.
Yes, and it's always now good that people have realized that our cultures need to be embraced, because we get to have an international concert and you see overwhelming the culture event which we had just organized. But with such events that are now coming up, I believe we are getting back to have the value of who we are.
Do you think our society of late is really losing touch with our culture?
Yeah, it is. It is, and that's why I believe with now such concepts that are coming up,
mm-hmm.
probably people who will be coming through to such events, they'll get back and get back to the right position of knowing how things are done, how do they greet, how do they put on here. Because I think these are things we're going to experience at my culture, my identity.
Yeah.
Yes, because it will be able to identify you that, okay, Lenzo, this is who you are. John Paul, this is who you are.
Yeah.
So I believe the digital that we are now getting into with such events, it will get a bit stagnant and a bit slow.
Thank you very much for joining us here on the show, John Paul.
It was a pleasure having me here tonight.
It was a pleasure having you here, and we leave you with a little bit of the Ciroc Pop Night that happened just last week at Governor. Thank you so much for watching the show as well and for keeping in touch with us on social media, especially at Urban TV Uganda. My personal one's at Denzel UG. You have yourselves a good evening. Thank you very much for watching Backstage Pass.
Gentlemen, how are you doing, my brother?
I'm all right.
Should I- appreciate the blazer, first of all. I like the fact that you're putting on red. Red is one of those colors that I myself love putting on apart from tonight, you know. What's your name?
My name is Nelson.
Nelson?
Yeah, Nelson Songoyo.
You look like you're from Germany. You don't look like someone who's been around Uganda, you know, for a while. You know?
No, I've been in Uganda for a while. Yeah. I'm from South Sudan, but I've been basing here for a while.
So what do you think about the night, you know?
It's amazing. And
what is so amazing about it? Is it the girls? Is it because we have free drinks on the house? Or but there is something amazing about it, you know?
The house is full of all. Like, the participants are active. Uh-huh. You know, the dance already, like, you know, the energy, there's energy, yes, there's energy. Yeah.
I like everything about the show, the drinks, everything, the performance. Mm. I just love everything because it teaches us a lot.
Okay.
Yeah.
You in person, do you have a contestant that you're affiliated to that you love so much and you love to maybe, perhaps, maybe a male or female, I don't care. Like, you feel like they should become the new Mr. or Miss for you?
Yeah, I do, but let me say all of them are my friends, so.
Come on. Yeah? We all have friends. Okay, tell me, who's your best friend among the contestants? Or closest? Okay, closest friend, you know?
Closest. Uh-huh. But just a friend.
Okay, just a friend. That is so close. Okay, someone who has visited you at home, perhaps, or you have visited, because I believe not everybody has visited you, right?
I don't. No. I don't have any of them, but they're just my friends of class, books. That's it.
And look who I just found right about now, first runner up. Ah, man, I don't know what happens when you guys are in boot camp, because they teach a lot of this, you know. Does it mean that if I find you somewhere, maybe in a taxi, and I'm like, yo, how are you, what's up? You'll be like,
yeah, I should do that.
What's your name?
Akwal Zakaria Deng.
Yes. Are you from South Africa?
I'm from South Sudan.
You look amazing tonight. Should you have a stylist, or it's just you going to downtown and choose a dress, you know?
It's just me going to downtown and choose a dress.
Now that you've actually been first runner up, I'm wondering, personally, what that one thing that Viu is going to remember you about, because, I mean, tonight we're saying bye-bye to you and we're having some new beautiful lady. You're so old now, you know?
Viu is going to remember me for my outstanding friendship with each and everyone. I am really friendly to each and everyone.